In this video, we're continuing on with the CUDA Software Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Multiplying Radical Expressions. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now for number 11, we're going to need to distribute the square root of 3. It will get multiplied to both the 5 and the square root of 3. So we'll have the square root of 3 times 5 plus the square root of 3 times the square root of 3. Now, the square root of 3 times 5, I'll rewrite putting that whole number first. So 5 times the square root of 3, and then we'll add that to the square root of 3 times the square root of 3, which is the square root of 3 times 3, but 5 times the square root of 3 plus the square root of 3 times 3 is the square root of 3 squared, so that square root will cancel out that exponent of 2, since the square root of 3 squared is 3. So we'll have 5 times the square root of 3 plus 3 as our solution in number 11. Continuing on to number 12, this time we're going to need to distribute 2 times the square root of 5. That will get multiplied to the square root of 6 and multiplied to 2. So we'll have 2 times the square root of 5 times the square root of 6 plus 2 times the square root of 5 times the whole number 2. 2 times the square root of 5 times the square root of 6 is 2 times the square root of 5 times 6. And then we'll add that to 2 times 2, which is 4 times the square root of 5. Simplifying 2 times the square root of 5 times 6, we'll get 2 times the square root of 30, since 5 times 6 is 30, and we'll add that to 4 times the square root of 5. And there's not a perfect square that goes into 30, so we cannot simplify this problem anymore. 2 times the square root of 30 plus 4 times the square root of 5 is our solution in number 12. In number 13, we'll be distributing negative 3 times the square root of 3. That will get multiplied to the 2, and it will get multiplied to the square root of 6 with addition in between. So we'll have negative 3 times the square root of 3 times our whole number 2 plus negative 3 times the square root of 3 times the square root of 6. So that's negative 3 times 2, which is negative 6 times the square root of 3 plus negative 3 times the square root of 3 times 6, which is 18. Because we'll have the square root of 3 times 6, and 3 times 6 is 18, so we'll have negative 3 times the square root of 18. Now I'm going to simplify, because there is a perfect square that can go into 18. And that perfect square is 9. 9 times 2 equals 18, so I'll rewrite 9 as 3 squared times 2. So we'll have negative 6 times the square root of 3 plus negative 3 times the square root of 18, which I'll write as 3 squared times 2. Now, I'll be able to pull out that whole number 3 since it has an exponent of 2. So we'll have negative 6 times the square root of 3 plus negative 3 times 3 times the square root of 2. So that's negative 6 times the square root of 3 plus negative 3 times 3, which is negative 9, times the square root of 2. That's my solution in number 13. In number 14, I'm going to be distributing the square root of 3. That will get multiplied to negative 5 times the square root of 10, and then multiply to the square root of 6 with addition in between those terms. So we'll have the square root of 3 times negative 5 times the square root of 10, plus square root of 3 times the square root of 6. So we'll have negative 5 times the square root of 3 times 10, and I'll add that to the square root of 3 times 6. So that's negative 5 times the square root of 30 plus the square root of 3 times 6 is 18. Now, just in the previous problem, 18 can be written as 9 times 2, which is 3 squared times 2. So negative 5 times the square root of 30 plus the square root of 3 squared times 2. Now I'll be able to pull out that 3, essentially simplifying the square root of 18. By pulling out that 3, I'll have negative 5 times the square root of 30 plus 3 times the square root of 2 as my solution in number 14. And again, 3 times the square root of 2 is just a simplified form of the square root of 18. Continuing on to the second page, number 15, we're distributing negative 2 times the square root of 15. That will get multiplied to negative 3 times the square root of 3 and 3 times the square root of 5 with addition in between. So we'll have negative 2 times the square root of 15 times negative 3 times the square root of 3 plus negative 2 times the square root of 15 times 3 times the square root of 5. So first I'll start by multiplying negative 2 to negative 3 to get a positive 6, and that will get multiplied by the square root of 15 times the square root of 3, which is the square root of 15 times 3. And then I'll multiply negative 2 by positive 3 to get negative 6. So I'll have negative 6 times the square root of 15 times the square root of 5, which is the square root of 15 times 5. So I'll have 6 times the square root of 15 times 3, which is 45. So 6 times the square root of 45 plus negative 6 times the square root of 15 times 5, which is the square root of 75. Now, both 45 and 75 have a perfect square that goes into each of them. Therefore, those square roots can be simplified. So 45 is 9 times 5, which is 3 squared times 5. And 75 is 25 times 3, which is 5 squared times 3. So we'll have 6 times the square root of 3 squared times 5 plus negative 6 times the square root of 5 squared times 3. Pulling out a 3 from our first radical and a 5 from our second radical, we'll have 6 times 3 times the square root of 5 plus negative 6 times 5 times the square root of 3. 6 times 3 is 18, so we'll have 18 times the square root of 5 plus negative 6 times 5 is negative 30. So we'll be adding a negative 30, but as opposed to adding, we'll subtract a positive 30 times the square root of 3. 18 times the square root of 5 minus 30 times the square root of 3. Moving on to number 16, we'll distribute 5 times the square root of 42x. That will get multiplied to 4, and it will get multiplied to 4 times the square root of 7x. So we'll have 5 times the square root of 42x, and we're multiplying that by 4, and then adding it to 5 times the square root of 42x times 4 times the square root of 7x. Now let's simplify. 5 times 4 is 20, so we'll have 20 times the square root of 42x, and then we'll add that to 5 times 4, which again is 20 times the square root of 42x times the square root of 7x is the square root of 42x times 7x. Simplifying, we'll get 20 times the square root of 42x plus 20 times the square root of, since multiplication is commutative, I'll multiply 42 by 7 to get 294, and then I'll multiply x by x to get x squared. So notice I can pull out that base of x since it has an exponent of 2. So I'll have 20 times the square root of 42x plus 20 times x, pulling out my base of x, and then I'll multiply that by the square root of 294. However, 294 is equal to a perfect square times some other number, and that's 49 times 6, where 49 is that perfect square, 7 squared. So I'll write this as 7 squared times 6. Now, I'll be able to pull out a 7 in my next step. So I'll have 20 times the square root of 42x plus 7, pulling out that 7, times 20x times the square root of 6. Now, all I need to do is multiply 7 by 20, which is 140. So I'll have 20 times the square root of 42x plus 7 times 20, which is 140, times x times the square root of 6. So my solution in number 16 is 20 times the square root of 42x plus 140x times the square root of 6. Moving on to number 17, I'm going to be distributing the square root of 14x. That entire quantity will get multiplied to 3, and then it will get multiplied to the square root of 2x. However, there's subtraction in between these two terms. So I'll have the square root of 14x times 3 minus, because of that subtraction, the square root of 14x times the square root of 2x. So we'll have 3 times the square root of 14x. Because multiplication is commutative, I'll write the 3 in front. And then the square root of 14x times 2x is the square root of 14 times 2, which is 28. And then that 28 is multiplied by x times x, which is x squared. So right away, I'll be able to pull out that base of x. Because 14x times 2x is 28x squared, I can pull out that base of x. So I'll have 3 times the square root of 14x minus x times the square root of 28. However, there's a perfect square that goes into 28. 28 is equal to 4 times 7, where 4 is that perfect square, which is 2 squared. So 2 squared times 7 equals 28. So I'll rewrite the square root of 28 as the square root of 2 squared times 7, since I already pulled out that x, because the square root of x squared is x. Now, I'll be able to take out this base of 2. So I'll have 3 times the square root of 14x minus 2 times x, pulling out that 2, times the square root of 7. That's my solution in number 17. In number 18, I'm multiplying the square root of 6n. That gets multiplied to 7n cubed, and the square root of 12 with addition in between those terms. So I'll have 7n cubed times the square root of 6n plus the square root of 6n times the square root of 12 is the square root of 6n times 12. Because both are within a radical, I can multiply together under the same radical. So I'll have 7n cubed times the square root of 6n plus 6 times 12, which is 72, so that's the square root of 72n. Now there's a perfect square that goes into 72. 72 is equal to 36 times 2, where 36 is that perfect square, 6 squared. So 6 squared times 2 equals 72. So I'll have 7n cubed times the square root of 6n plus the square root of 72n, which is the square root of 6 squared times 2 times n, since 6 squared times 2 is 72. Because it has an exponent of 2 that's within the square root, I'll get 7n cubed times the square root of 6n plus 6 times the square root of 2n. So 7n cubed times the square root of 6n plus 6 times the square root of 2n. In number 19, I'll distribute the square root of 3b. That gets multiplied to the square root of 6 and the square root of 10. So I'll have the square root of 3b times 6, because they're both within radicals, I'll multiply them under the same radical, and then add that to the square root of 3b times 10. Because again, they're both under the square root, so I can multiply them together under the same square root. So 3b times 6 is 18b, so I'll have the square root of 18b plus the square root of 3b times 10, which is the square root of 30b. Now the square root of 18b can be simplified because the square root of 18 can be simplified. 18 can be written as 9 times 2, which is the perfect square 3 squared, times 2. So we'll have the square root of 3 squared times 2 times v plus the square root of 30v. Pulling out that 3, I'll have 3 times the square root of 2v plus the square root of 30v. That's my solution in number 19. Now lastly in this video, I'll go over number 20. Before I do this, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Now I'm going to distribute the square root of 21r, multiplying it to 5, and multiplying it to the square root of 7 with addition in between those two terms. So we'll have 5 times the square root of 21r plus the square root of 21r times 7. Because both 7 and 21r are within that square root, they can be multiplied together under the same square root. So we'll have 5 times the square root of 21r plus 21 times 7 is 147, and we're multiplying that by r, so we'll have the square root of 147r. Now, 147 can be written as a perfect square times some number, because a perfect square is a multiple of 147. 147 is divisible by 49. So 147 is 49 times 3. That's 7 squared times 3. So we'll have 5 times the square root of 21r plus the square root of 7 squared times 3 times r. So pulling out that 7, because it has an exponent of 2 under that square root, I'll get 5 times the square root of 21r plus 7 times the square root of 3r. That's my final solution in this video. If you didn't do so before number 20, remember to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Continue on to the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 21 through 28.